Well, we started this about 5 years ago, just on a whim.
3, 2, 1.
And the kids enjoyed it so much, we've been doing it ever since.
Alan Williams, the head physics teacher at Atherton High School, says this project helps students apply what they're learning in the classroom to the real world.
Primarily, we look at the physics of rockets, we go look at the construction, the different types of materials, and then finally we look at the competition piece.
This is the first year Atherton invited other schools to compete. The competition is based on a point system, starting with how high the rocket goes into the air. Inside of each rocket is an altimeter that tells you how many feet in the air the rocket went. The nose cone and the fins are 3D printed, and there's a parachute inside so the students can get back what they sent into the air. Students designed the shape and the size and added some creativity to the rockets.
Well, we made the nose cone on the shape to reduce drag, an elliptical shape, and it also, we made it as light as possible. And then for the fins, we made it very geometric so it could be more aerodynamic.
There's a pipe here with 3 layers of circles to hold each item, like the parachute, the altimeter, and there's a little battery thing right there. Electric charge run through it and it pops.
Good job!
Some flew sky high, others not so much. But either way, students got a first-hand view at a career in STEM.
This really took a lot of work in like a minute. So kind of taught me critical thinking because I had to think really quick.
I'm wanting to do something with rockets in my future.
Addie Miners, WLKY News.
Thank you, Addie.